Welcome to D2L Brightspace Course Navigation for Students Part 2. In this video, we will explore the Materials menu in the Course Navigation bar. We'll focus on the course calendar and the content links. Remember, you can enter a course from the Brightspace Momentum home screen by clicking on the Select a Course icon in the mini navigation bar at the very top of the screen or under the My Courses widget. As you enter a course, you'll notice a few changes to your screen. The name of the course is visible in the mini navigation bar to the right of the Roan State logo. The course homepage typically includes a news item welcoming you to the course calendar, and the course updates widget. Always pay close attention to the calendar and updates widgets for the latest course information. As you learned in the previous module, time management is crucial for online students. The calendar maintains a log of important dates throughout the duration of your course. The calendar is updated with specific due dates and upcoming events as your instructor makes changes to the course. There are 5 different ways to view your course calendar: agenda, day, week, month, and list view. You can create a to-do list by adding tasks to your calendar, which you can print at any time. Your online learning experience begins with the course content, which is where you will spend the majority of your time within your class. The content section consists of 3 parts: the table of contents, the user progress bar, and the content window. There are 3 icons directly above the table of contents. The overview icon, which looks like a small presentation or projection screen, links to a short summary of the course, and your instructor may upload introductory materials within the overview section. The bookmarks icon allows you to save items or topics within a module to read later. The course schedule icon is another tool to help you stay on track in your course. Clicking on this link presents you with a condensed schedule of upcoming events and a full schedule or complete list of events with the option to print both schedules. The table of contents appears in the left-hand side of the page and displays all the materials within the course. The table of contents consists of modules. Clicking on a module within the table of contents will display all materials for that section of the course. The main modules within the table of contents may contain smaller submodules, which further organize the course content into smaller sections. Each module will include a list of learning objectives, learning outcomes, and instructions for completing the module, along with all relevant materials and resources. The numbers in the orange boxes within the table of contents represent the number of items or topics within each module. The user progress bar appears at the top of the screen within each module inside of the table of contents. This bar helps learners gauge which tasks and topics they have completed in each module. Please note that the check marks that appear next to each module topic are not always an accurate measure of your course progress. For example, simply navigating to some items within the content will yield a check mark or a completion percentage. These check marks only indicate that you have viewed a content topic. However, other items require students to submit assignments or complete a specific task before they receive a check mark, so not all check marks contribute to your grade. Furthermore, it is often not necessary for students to view or complete all items within a module. Some content topics may be optional and thus can remain incomplete and unchecked. Check with your instructor and syllabus to better understand your participation grade. Above the progress bar are 2 icons labeled Download and Send to Binder. You have the option to download any content or send any content to the D2L Binder app to use on a mobile device. These icons provide you with options to print and read your content in other formats offline. You'll notice a printer icon in the upper right-hand corner that allows you to print the current screen. Selecting either the Expand All or Collapse All link underneath the printer icon helps you to navigate the content. When the menu is expanded, the materials associated with each module are revealed. In collapsed view, only the titles of the modules are visible. You'll notice that as you click on the modules in the table of contents, the content window changes to reveal the specific topics related to that learning module. A small icon is visible underneath the title of each content topic, indicating what type of item it is. The number in the orange box that appears in each module represents the number of incomplete topics remaining. As you explore each module, you will notice the breadcrumb trail that appears beneath the course navigation bar. This trail of hyperlinks will help you locate where you are within the course content. The organization of topics within a module is very specific. Generally, the course topics are meant to be completed in the order in which they appear, so it's typically best to start from top to bottom within the module. However, please refer to your syllabus or contact your instructor for clarification. Each instructor designs his or her course differently. You will notice that the course layout and the links in each of the menus in the course navigation bar will vary from course to course. However, the course navigation bar is always visible. The course navigation bar consists of four menus: Materials, Communication, Assessments, and My Tools. These categories are organized in a manner which makes it easy to quickly access everything you need in your class. It is recommended that you view the additional video tutorials and resources provided within this module for more help with navigating the Materials menu. In the next video, we will discuss how to navigate the Communication menu.